All right. Well, hello and welcome. Welcome in. Hello. Today is Thursday. Oh, which means that it is vlog day. And yeah, you know what, you guys? I have a great vlog for you guys tonight. We got a whole mess of stuff to talk. This is, in reality, the last vlog before August 8th. This is the last vlog before August 8th. Today is Thursday. We have Friday, Saturday, Sunday. That's it. Monday is actually August 8th. So we're going to be talking a lot about some advocacy stuff. Of course, we're going to have first impressions. Of course, we're going to have some beer. Of course, we're going to have shout outs. There is a getting to know GrimmGreen section in here where I take you with me to get tattooed on my chest. That's kind of the reason I'm wearing this shirt. I don't really wear this shirt very often. I found it in my closet and I'm like, hey, I used to really like that shirt and I never wear it anymore. And now I wear it. It's because, are you ready to see my chest? I'm going to open up my shirt here. I got Kylo Ren. Oh, tattooed. He's still tender. Can you believe that? Tattooed all up on my chesticles. And yeah, I shot some video. Oh my God, my lighting is falling down. Hang on. I apologize. Hold, please. So yeah, I shot some video of going up to visit Jay to get tattooed. So that should be really fun. But let me just dive right into this. Let me get into this vlog. First thing I have written down on my vlog notes is comments. I get a lot of comments and I really do my best. I get in there every single day and I'm replying to comments and I'm just replying to them and I'm replying to them. And a lot of comments, you know what? They go unanswered. And it's not because I don't like you or because I think your comment's dumb or I don't have an answer to your question. I have 800 videos on YouTube and 200 and something fucking ridiculous thousand subscribers on YouTube, and they're all getting commented on. 800 videos getting commented on, you know, constantly by these 200,000 plus people. So yeah, my comment feed when I go to YouTube is just miles long. So I get in there as best I can. I try to go to like my newer videos more because YouTube lets you filter it by like, oh, your newer videos, particular specific videos. So I try to get in there as much as I can, but don't be disheartened. Don't think that I'm a dick. Don't think that I don't like you, because of course I like you. You took the time to comment on my video. You're a good person. I do my best to get in there, but sometimes it just doesn't happen. Real quick update about the iPower. Yeah, I realized that I uploaded that video and it wasn't a great review for that particular device. I believe that I had a lemon device. Couldn't get it to work. It was locked. I tried resetting it. I tried updating the firmware. I tried resetting it correctly as suggested by the comments. Nothing fixed it. And it's not that I wanted to like destroy eLeaf. Their products can be pretty hit and miss. Sometimes they're hit, sometimes they're miss. It's not that I wanted to like tarnish the name of the iPower or, you know, poke fun at anybody that bought it and is using it and is enjoying it. I only uploaded that video to show that the one that I had didn't work correctly. It's a low percentage. You know what I mean? There's going to be lemons. There's going to be ones that don't work. Sometimes eLeaf has a little bit higher of a percentage of devices that are sometimes janky and don't work. It's just another perspective on a device that a lot of people are using. A lot of people have already reviewed. I can only ever review what I have in front of me. And unfortunately, what I had in front of me on Monday wasn't super great. Cool. If you have the iPower, use it, dude. Awesome. Cool. I'm glad it works for you. Mine did not. I only have one sample to go off of, and that one sample I had was Bucket. And so, you know, what am I going to do? I have to upload a video. I was going to talk more about the recoil, but I'm just not. There was a lot of interesting comments in that recoil video, and at the end of the day, you will not be able to please all of the people all of the time. Dwayne and I made this RDA for the way that we like to vape. We custom tailored it for the way that we like to vape. And so if someone else doesn't like to vape that way, then cool. I mean, that's not, we all vape different ways. I always say this, but if we all vape the same way, the world would be a very, very boring place. So some people don't like this and the top and the airflow and the thing, and cool, all good. We have plenty more recoils. This is not like a limited offer time thing. We have plenty of more recoils coming out, and should be should be really, really good. So I do have some advocacy to do as well before we talk about any new products that may or may not be coming out this week before August 8th. But I have this right here, and I believe this got posted on Facebook. Multiple people were posting this on Facebook, and this is from the vapes.com blog. So 7 senators have joined Ron Johnson to write FDA over these e-cig regulations. So you remember a couple of vlogs ago, I talked about Senator Ron Johnson and how he had written a firmly worded letter to the FDA saying, hey, you know, basically, what the hell you doing? This is government overreach. Hashtag, what the hell you doing? Sincerely, Senator Ron Johnson. And they replied back to him, and their response was, not what Ron Johnson was looking for. It was basically, we don't know, so we're going to regulate them, and then we're going to study them afterwards. And that was basically their response. And Ron Johnson went, that's not good enough. This is government overreach. That's not good enough. So not only is Ron Johnson back at it with the FDA because their response wasn't good enough, but he got 7 more senators to sign this letter and to be part of this. And what's great, this is great, this is what I love to see, it is bipartisan. We have Bill Nelson, Democrat, Florida. Bob Casey, Democrat, Pennsylvania. John Tester, Democrat, Montana. Mark Rubio, Republican, Florida. Robert Mendez, Democrat, New Jersey. Joe Mitchkin, Democrat, West Virginia. And James, I'm going to butcher your last names, James. I don't know if you watch my vlog. James Inhofe. Anyway, Republican from Oklahoma. Bipartisan support for Ron Johnson, kind of confronting, going up against the FDA. I'm going to link in the description to the article on vapes.com, their vlog. It's a good article. It's a really good read. It's a lot to read. I mean, I'm not going to sit here and read the whole thing, but the gist of it is seven senators total. Wait, did I say 6 or 7? Yeah, 7 senators total are siding with Ron Johnson, Senator Ron Johnson, about this. And, you know, I don't want to get into political thing. I don't like talking about politics. I'm a libertarian. That's cool. If you're not, that's cool too. Whatever. Everybody has different views on stuff. We have to be careful that I know that a lot of us are single issue people, and me, yeah, I've become a single issue person. I want vaping to stay alive and remain safe and legal and accessible to not only vapers, but for smokers around the world. That's my platform. That's what I stand on. Senator Ron Johnson, while he is absolutely going to bat for us against the FDA, against the Food and Drug Administration, Senator Ron Johnson is also very anti-free internet. So pick your battles, you know what I mean? Pick your issues that you agree and disagree with people on. As much support as we throw behind Ron Johnson against these FDA regulations, we have to remember that other views that he has, some of us, myself included, might not agree with. He's very, very anti-internet, which kind of really rubs me the wrong way. But you know what? You pick your battles. You get there. You get there when you get there. So absolutely. I'll post a link down to that in the description. What else do I have? Oh, I mentioned this on the podcast. And this is just heartbreaking. This is just straight up seriously heartbreaking. I mentioned this in the last Culture of Clouds podcast, but poor Poland is having an outright 100% prohibition ban on everything vape related. Poland is taking the TPD and just enforcing it to the letter of the law. They are banning use, sales, anything. You can't order it online. There'll be no brick and mortar shops. You are not allowed to leave the country to get it and bring it back into the country. You could be penalized, fined, and jailed. So Poland is in a really, really bad spot right now. My heart goes out to the vapers and smokers of Poland because that is horrible. It's hard to keep up with United States laws. It's hard to keep up with state and local government laws. It's difficult to keep up with worldwide stuff. And I don't know what's going on in Poland. I don't know if they have any advocacy groups set up. If they don't and you're in Poland, fucking start one so that you can do something about this. Vapor products should be encouraged to be used for vapers, for smokers. They're unbelievable. We all know that. I all know, you know, we've said this about a billion times, but my heart goes out to the vapers and smokers of Poland. I think that is just horrible. I'll link down in the description to the vaping360.com website where I read that article. What else do we have going on here? So this note just says, Doug Facebook, Greg, Indiana. Doug Facebook, Greg, Indiana. No idea what that means. Let's open the link and find out. Ah, okay. So Doug from Facebook sent me this. That's the person that sent me this. There is a politician, candidate, Democratic gubernatorial candidate John Gregg, said if elected, he would seek to change the new laws governing the e-cigarette liquid industry, which some vaping retailers and manufacturers have called monopolistic and corrupt. So, that's right. This is important. There's a guy running for Senate in Indiana. His name is John Gregg. Gregg. He says if he's elected, which, okay, I get it. We don't trust a lot of politicians. He says if he's elected, he would seek to change the laws in Indiana that govern e-cigs, e-liquid, everything they have going on in Indiana, which is freaking ridiculous. He would seek to change those laws, which, you know what? If you're going to throw your support behind someone, behind a politician in your local city or state, it would be best to probably throw your support behind a pro-vaping candidate. That just makes sense to me. If there was a candidate in California that was running against, Feinstein or Barbara Boxer, who said, hey, I vape, I am pro-vaping, I will seek to change the vape laws in California, I would go, you have my vote, and I will get everyone I know to vote for you. Yes, absolutely. We are unfortunately single-issue voters at this point, and you got to throw your weight. You got to throw your weight and support behind lawmakers, potential senators, potential representatives that support vaping, and tobacco harm reduction. Gosh, sometimes I just sound like a broken record. What else do I have? Amanda M. Let's talk about Amanda M. real fast. I do have some products I want to show you guys that we're coming out with before August 8th, but I want to talk about Amanda M. real fast. Now, Amanda M. is just, I just love her. She is my favorite Canadian on earth. She runs a, daily vlog channel on YouTube. She used to do reviews. I've known her since 2011, I think, is when I first met Amanda M. She is just a sweetheart. She is incredibly passionate about vaping, and she is in Canada. In Canada? What? Canada. Canadia. Canada. Anyway, she is doing a fundraiser for the Mudderella 2016 event. And when I first read this, Amanda, I'm not gonna lie, I thought it said Murderella, and I was like, that is a pretty fucking metal name for an event. Turns out that it's Mudderella, like the tough mudder competitions. And I'm just gonna read this quick blurb she has, and I'm gonna be posting a link to this in the description. She says, hi, my name is Amanda. I will be participating in the Mudderella 2016 in Whistler, British Columbia. Mudderella events are created as a physical endurance course and take place in a variety of locations in the United States and Canada. Their organization supports many great causes, including Canadian Breast Cancer Foundation and Futures Without Violence. As a participant, you have the option to fundraise for these causes. However, I'd like to put my own twist on fundraising for this event. I'm participating in this event not only as a challenge to myself, but to prove that my health has greatly improved since I quit smoking and started using an e-cig, vaping. I've been part of the vaping industry since 2011, and my passion has never faded. Vaping saves lives. It helps millions of people put down their cigarettes and take their first steps to a healthier lifestyle. I am living proof of that. All donations gathered from this fundraiser will be split 50-50. Half of the donations will go to CASA to show support for everything that they have done and continue to do, and keep the vaping industry alive and thriving. The other half of the donations will be given to the Canadian Cancer Society. I have set the fundraising goal to $2,000. Easily attainable. Easily attainable. I personally have more than 3,500 friends on Facebook. That means that if each of my friends donated $1, the goal amount would be almost doubled. I know we can do this. Thanks in advance for your support. Please go to this. $1. That's it. One freaking dollar. And it's going to a good cause. The money's going to go to CASA. It's going to go to the Canadian Cancer Society. And it's going to help motivate Miss Canadian Amanda M. to get through the Mudderella 2016. And I don't know if you guys have ever seen these like Mudderella Tough Mudder events. They are brutal. Like just something that I have no interest in ever doing ever in my life. I would just never do it. She is a badass and I love her. So absolutely, Amanda, put a link down in the description in the other category, I think. Maybe in the advocacy category, but definitely somewhere down in the description. I will have a link to this crowdrise.com, Amanda's Mudderella. Totally cool. Totally cool, Amanda. I commend you for doing that. Absolutely, I commend you for doing that. So, yeah. What else do I even have to talk about? Oh, so people keep asking me to call people out, and I don't want to do that. I'm not a person that's going to, I don't like to call people out. Evidently, there's some vendors and some people and blah, 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 and drama happening. And there was, someone had sent me some screen captures of a conversation that they had with a vendor on Instagram. And he had asked said vendor, oh, well, what are you going to do to support advocacy to get through the FDA regulations, PMTAs, and all this stuff? And the vendor's response was basically, I don't really care about any of that. I'm just going to make money until I can't anymore. And then I'm going to watch the vape industry burn down or something to that effect. It was really harsh and really like took me by surprise. Now, let me know what you think. Is it my job to call out this vendor? Do you even want to know who it is? Not just for drama's sake, but for advocacy's sake. Do we care about vendors? I mean, obviously we should be supporting vendors that support advocacy, right? I mean, that's been like the theme song. Everybody has said this, support vendors that support advocacy. Absolutely. If there's vendors that are knowingly out there and selling stuff, maybe they should be called out for not supporting advocacy, not just not supporting advocacy, but going like against advocacy, saying, I don't care about any of that. I'm just going to make money until I can't make money anymore. And then I'm going to leave the vape industry and let it burn down on its own. Wow. Like, wow. Is it my job to call them out? Should we be calling them out? Should we be holding each other accountable? Just trying to get this sort of conversation started. Let me know down in the comments below. What you think? I may never call this vendor out, but just be aware of things like this. If you see it on social media and you see a vendor who's like, eh, fuck advocacy. Yeah, I don't give a shit and stuff like that. Just talk to him. Just approach him. Just get some information. I'm not in the business of calling people out, but that doesn't mean that other people can't call people out. Anyway, let's move forward from that. So, like I said, everybody and their mother is scrambling to the finish line for August 8th. If you don't know, August 8th is the last day that we have, before August 8th is the last day that any vendor has to release any products into the market. After August 8th, there is a freeze on the market, which means that after August 8th, you will see no new juices, no new mods, no new atomizers. There are some loopholes that people are trying to get through. I don't know. There could be loopholes, but I personally, for my company, I am playing it safe and we are getting out all of our products before August 8th. These are potentially the last products that we will release as Namberjuice. So it's kind of depressing, but I'm also on the same hand really super excited about these products. And I don't want this to sound like an infomercial or anything. The first thing we're doing is re-releasing the Grim Cult line in 60 milligram bottles. These are 60 milligram CPC certified caps. We have paperwork certified caps. New Grim Cult 60 mils. Same flavors, bigger bottles, same price. So it's $25 for a 60 mil bottle. You're getting 60 mils for $25. I worked day and night and slaved over a hot computer monitor. You're not going to be able to appreciate this, but we completely redid the labels. They have a much cooler, cleaner look now. In fact, that's the Yig bottle. Let me show you in comparison. They're all color-coded. So the Caramel Corpse is red, the Yig is green, and the Sherbet in the Dark is purple. They all have this, like, very sort of, I don't know, sexy vampire chick on it. It says Grim Cult, it says Caramel Corpse, it says Grim Cult, it says Yig. That's the first thing. That's something that I've been wanting to change for a while now. It was supposed to change later in the year, but due to August 8th, it had to change before that, because after August 8th, you're not allowed to change your labels, change the way they look, change the font on your label. You are not allowed to change the font on your label after August 8th. So we have to get all of our ducks in a row before August 8th, you see. Additionally, we are exclusively on Namberjuice carrying two very cool products. And I apologize if this sounds like an infomercial. I just want to get it out there and make everyone aware of it. We're carrying the new Axton Hughes juice line. So I don't know if anybody has been in the vape industry long enough to remember Axton Hughes, but Axton Hughes released a couple of mods back in the day. And back in the day, when I first met Daniel from Axton Hughes, he was working on a juice line. And this juice line, 5 years later, is just now coming into fruition. And so we are going to exclusively have it on namberjuice.com. Yes, Axton Hughes on namberjuice.com. It's the first place that you'll be able to get it ever. Like I said, it's literally like 5 years in the making. 5 years in the making. And keep in mind, all of this stuff, Cult, Axton, and the next juice line, that I'm about to talk about, it's all available tonight at midnight, starting Friday morning, starting tonight at night, tonight at midnight, when it turns into Friday, boom, that shit will all be available, and I am just so relieved. All this stuff has been on our plate for the last, like, 6 months, and now it's just finally coming out. Now, I don't have any of the Axton bottles on me, but I did get sent a very cool video. Now, this isn't how they're going to come packaged. It's not going to be in this, like, cybernetic piston-powered opening device, but the labels are adulty and classy looking. I have not yet got to seen these bottles in real life, but they look just super cool, super adult, super grown up. The flavors are delicious, and we're gonna have it exclusively on namberjuice.com, and I'm honestly really excited about it. If any of the old Axton fans remember this brand, It's probably something to get excited about. Now, these juices aren't cheap. These juices are a little bit more on the expensive side. I don't have the exact numbers at this moment, but they're a little bit more on the expensive side. But I know that we're going to do a deal where if you buy all of the juices, you get it for half price. So Thursday at midnight, just go look at the site, see what the prices are. These are, I hate this word. I hate the word. These are premium juices. They're a little bit more expensive. We're gonna do a deal if you get all of them, but you can only get these on Namberjuice. We got the first batch of them, and I'm honestly really excited about it. So that's something to look out for. So lastly, and then I promise that this infomercial is over. We have, because there's a lot of people involved. We have been working on this juice line for what seems like forever. I just literally on Tuesday finally got the final labels done. This juice line has stuck in my craw for so long. I want it to be perfect. I want it to be flawless. This is for the Grim Army. This is for my supporters who, you know, in the face of adversity and overwhelming regulations, have not backed down and continued to fight the good fight. I wanted this just to be something very, very special. So what we're releasing again tonight, midnight, Friday, is the GrimmGreen Signature Line. It's three flavors. They come in 100 mil bottles only, and it's $35. I feel like that is a pretty screaming deal. 100 mils, $35. There are three flavors. Now, these aren't the final label designs. This was one revision that I did that I wasn't super stoked on. It's my logo. It has the juice flavor down here. It has 100 milliliters, and this is a 0 milligram bottle. And then, of course, you know, if we want to sell it, we have to put, you know, we have to dedicate what, an entire inch of label space to every freaking weird warning on earth, including California Prop 65. So yeah, absolutely. Thanks, California. Anyway, I'm incredibly proud of this juice line. A lot of people worked really hard to finally get this out. Like I said, I literally just finished the labels on Tuesday, like the final versions of the labels. Anyway, it's three flavors. There's Normal View, which is this one. There is Vlog Day, and there is Bro Trip. Those are my three flavors. Those represent this channel and me as a person. The graphics represent me, the flavors represent me, and the flavor names represent me and this channel. Normal View, obviously, that's just a cool name anyway, but that's from my weekly review series. Vlog Day, that is today. Today is Vlog Day, and now there is a juice to commemorate this glorious day. And Bro Trip. And Bro Trip was specifically flavor profile-wise designed to be appealing to my best bro in the whole world, Dwayne, Omboy OC. I made this juice behind his back. I made this juice. We made this juice. A lot of people worked on this juice behind Dwayne's back. And then just like a week ago, when we went to go see Slayer, I let him taste it for the first time, and he said, bro, that's legit. We custom tailored this juice to fit his flavor palette almost exactly. Bro Trip is a strawberry peach limeade, and it is freaking stellar. I absolutely love it. Vlog Day is a lemon cream macaroon flavor. It's freaking delicious. And Normal View is a cranberry orange sugar cookie. These flavors are stellar. I am biased. These flavors are stellar. I'm going to get some of these flavors out to just different people to get some feedback, this, that, and the other. But I am so excited about these. 100 mils, $35, three flavors, available on namberjuice.com Thursday at midnight. Now, the infomercial is absolutely over. Thank you, everyone, for the support over the years. I mean, this channel wouldn't be shit. I mean, truly and honestly, without you guys, without the Grim Army, without my viewers that I love so much. God damn it. Give me a hug. Come here. So yeah, before we do getting to know GrimmGreen, I do want to talk about what I have been vaping. I'm going to keep this nice and short. Axis Vapes M17. Bought this. Love this. Great mod. Kennedy 24, two post on top. And finally, I can talk about it. Instead of saying super secret juice, this is Bro Trip. I've vaped so much. I've vaped so much Bro Trip. The strawberry peach limeade, it is, it's amazing. It's been hot down here in sunny Southern California, and the strawberry peach limeade is so freaking refreshing. Just a good vape. It's even just a little bit throaty, just so Dwayne likes it more. I made it just a touch throaty. No big surprises here. That freaking noisy cricket back in solid rotation. I put a Culture of Cloud sticker on it. This is the new J-Bo Silin. It can be a tank or an RDA, and I much prefer it in RDA mode. It's got this sort of really interesting single coil bottom side airflow setup. I'm going to talk about it in the first impressions a little bit more. I got it topped with a DHD drip tip from DHD Designs, which I'll be linking to in the description as well. What juice is in here? Yig is in here. Delicious. Okay. So my button's been acting wonky again. Button's been acting really wonky again on this Cricut. Anyway, that's been really good as well. A lot of these I'm going to actually talk about in the first impressions. This is the new device from Hot Sig, and its name is the wrong door panel. All good. You know what I mean? This is the R150. Yes, I'm going to be talking about this a little bit more in the first impressions. It's their 150-watt device. I have it topped with a Goon RDA, which, god damn it, I love the Goon RDA. I can't help it. It's just a really solid RDA. 528 Custom Vapes and Blue-Eyed Goon, you guys did a great job on this RDA. I'm currently dripping Fat Panda juice, which, you know, I'm going through it steadily. It's not necessarily my favorite juice, but it is rather tasty. This is called Fruity Cookie. I got to hang out with Jen a little bit at VCCPA. Stole a bottle of this in 3 milligram, and it's been quite nice, quite just fruity, tasty, delicious. 0.13 ohm alien at 75 watts. It's a very crackly, listen. Do you hear how crackly this vape is? It's super crackly. The power cut out on me. My batteries are dead. Did you see that? Dead. Need to replace those batteries. Well, good to know. Good to know that when your batteries get low, it'll just stop firing. Anyway, I'll put some new batteries in that before we get to the first impressions, I promise. Also been rocking the Joe Lit 44 mod, man. We were talking about this on the podcast and how Ruby's husband, Josh, this is like his main vape. And I'm like, damn, I need to break out my 44. So I broke out my 44. I got this with the... what tank is that? The pivot tank on top. It's just been a surprisingly good vape. I mean, not surprisingly. I'm honestly just surprised I like this tank so much. It's just a single coil RTA, but it gives me nice flavor. I got it. It's a 0.6 ohm single coil on here. I have the massive 44 set to a whopping 38 watts. I've been getting days of battery life on this. The Jolit 44 at 38 watts will literally last you days, and it's fantastic. It's just so reliable. Yeah, good vape. Good vape. Nice restricted lung hit on this pivot tank. Just good all around. So lastly, this is something I'm going to talk about in my first impressions as well. This is the new stabilized wood Minikin. I got a little story to tell about this, but we'll tell that when we get to the first impressions. I've got the recoil addy on top with some Dude Juice Jade. This juice reminds me of the bro trip to VPX Vegas with me and Kent and Dwayne. I vaped this the entire time out of a K-Fun. It tastes just awesome in this recoil. You know what? Whatever. I'm biased. I love the airflow on the recoil. I put this little beauty ring that they send with the Minikin under the recoil, and it makes it look fancy. Like, it makes it look way more high-end than it really is. But 0.2 ohm, 74 watts. Looks like my batteries are dead. Awesome. Just dead batteries all around. Good. Oh, it's good. I love it. 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 So yeah, that's kind of what I've been vaping. I'm going to save some other stuff for the first impressions. We already talked about all the juices. We talked about Senator Ron Johnson. We talked about Amanda M. A whole bunch of stuff going on in there. Yeah, so right now I think it's time to watch me get tattooed. It's getting to know GrimmGreen. I'm heading up to Arcadia, California to get freaking tattooed. We've talked about tattoos before.
in the vlog which ones I have, who gave them to me. We talked about Mark, who gave me my first tattoo ever, and it's a road I'm glad I went down, but man, I fucking hate getting tattooed. Like, I hate it. Like, I hate it. I hate the process of getting tattooed. I just hate it. But I met this dude, Jay, at the VPX event in Las Vegas, and I apologize that my camera is so shaky right now, but I met this dude, Jay, at the VPX event in Las Vegas, and he's like, hey, bro, I'm a tattoo artist. I'm in Southern California. I'd love to tattoo you sometime. We've been talking on Instagram Messenger for a while, since the event. So we finally set a date, and today is that date, and I am driving up to Arcadia, California. Jay works at, owns, runs Black Talon? I want to say Blackthorn, but that just sounds like a magician. I think it's Black Talon Tattoo in Arcadia, California, and he's going to be doing up my chest, you see. We're getting some more Star Wars stuff done on my chest. I'm really looking forward to it because I haven't been tattooed in a number of years, and you know what? I'm long overdue, and I don't have anything on my chest right now, so it looks dumb when I take off my shirt. I feel like an idiot because I just have my throat tattooed and not my chest done, so we got to connect those dots. We got to get the chest done. So yeah, I'm going to tuck in for a nice little 2-hour drive up to Arcadia. I'm going to listen to my favorite, the Weekly Planet podcast, and I'm going to get the shit tattooed out of my chest. I also just want to say that traffic in Los Angeles, Orange County, is just the worst. I'm out of it now, but trust me when I say that it's the worst. I have to apologize to poor Jay. I'm like fucking 30 minutes late already, and I'm not even there yet, so I don't know. I'm new here. I don't know how to drive in Southern California, apparently. So I got here, despite traffic. Jay, yeah, that's the guy right there. He hooked it up with the serious, legit LA burrito, which is awesome because I was starving. Amazing burrito. East LA burrito.
There you go.
East LA burrito. So you know it's legit. And, yeah, we're gonna tattoo the fuck out of me. So that should be fun. And painful. And I'll hate it. But it's totally worth it. And, yeah, I'm gonna crush this burrito. Yeah. What?
It's like black and gray, right? So that's a bad picture.
What? It's happening. What's going on, me, dude?
An adventure can happen anytime, anywhere.
What? Well, don't mind me. I am shirtless, but we're watching Star Trek, so that's pretty cool. Also, Kylo Ren's happening. Yeah. That's happening on me. I apologize again for being shirtless. Hey, Spock. But, yeah. This is what I look like without a shirt, and that's Kylo Ren. Jay's doing just a bang-up job so far. Crazy. I forgot how much getting tattooed really, really hurts. It's just the worst. Worst. But yeah, we'll see it when it's done. Never get tattooed, viewers. Just never do it. Look at Jay smiling. Look at me getting fucking grilled.
I know you're gonna thank me at the end for all the pain.
Yeah, I probably will. That's the crazy part. It doesn't, on video, it kind of just looks, oh yeah, he's just painting on him. In actual life, it's quite painful. People always ask what it feels like to get tattooed. And it feels like if you got a really bad sunburn, and then someone started poking you with needles. I feel like that's a pretty accurate description. That's pretty good. So, but Jay's totally been super professional, making me as comfortable as I possibly can be. And, yeah, if you're in the Southern California area, Black Talon, Jay's pretty booked, from what I understand. But,
not for you, Jay.
For me, he says. Look at that. Oh, that looks sick. I love it. I love everything about it. I apologize. This is the first time my viewers have ever seen me topless, so... He's gonna get me subs.
He's just gonna be fried. Shave his chest.
Yeah, it was super hairy. Super hairy, but he shaved me. Another man shaved me.
Cost a little extra.
It's all part... Cost a little extra. It's all part of the process. Ooh. That's good. All right, I'm gonna stop filming now so that I can concentrate on the pain. Bro, gotta zoom in. Yes. Yes. Look at that. That's the mirror. Oh my god. Yeah. That is insane. Wow. Bro.
Not done yet.
Not even close. But still, that's a really fucking good start. Wow. So holy shit, dude. Yeah. Spent all day getting tattooed today with Jay at Black Talon Tattoo in Arcadia, California. Super cool guy. In fact, Jay does a couple of juice lines. He does that fresh. Remember the fresh that I talked about a while ago that really reminded me of the dynamite? He also does this stuff that I just got from Beyond Vape, actually. The Mango Me is super good. It's easily one of the best mango flavors I think I've ever had. So the Mango Me, which is the good one? Nope, the mango pineapple's good, but there's one that's just mango, right? It's just called Mango OG. Mango OG, super good. He has another one that is the mango milkshake, and I think I've already talked about this. It's got that like weird flavor, like cheesy flavor that I don't like. The Mango Me is unbelievable, but the mango milkshake, it's not for me. He also does, and I had no idea, drippin' fruits. I've seen these on Instagram. I've seen these guys at vape meets. Sour green apple and a watermelon flavor. I'm excited. He gave me a couple bottles of juice, and I really can't thank him enough. He did a stellar job on this Kylo Ren. There's a lot more to go. So if you're looking at this tattoo and you're like, bang, that looks bang, just keep in mind that was the first almost 5-hour session. There's a lot more to go. And I used to be a lot tougher, apparently, because I was really ready to tap out there at the end. But Jay wouldn't let me. He's like, no, bro, we're gonna do this. We're gonna add this shading. We're gonna add this color in here. And I'm like, you know what? You're the artist. Go do your artist thing. And really good. Really good experience. I'm glad I finally met this guy. I believe I met him at Vape Meets before. I definitely met him at VPX Vegas, but he's a super cool guy, really great artist, and he does some juice for the vape industry, which is super cool as well. So I guess that's going to wrap up this getting to know GrimmGreen. I don't know how long this segment is, so I might have to cut some other shit short, but whatever. You got to... Come with me to Tattoo Day. Yay, good times. All right, back to the vlog. All right, so let's taste some beer. I don't know, I'm shooting this beer segment, obviously, separately on a different day than I'm recording the normal vlog. In fact, I haven't even recorded
the normal vlog yet, and I just decided to get out my old microphone. I don't know why I'm always, look, I don't know why I'm always trying to change stuff up, and I'm like, oh, new camera, oh, get a Zoom mic, oh, get a new Rode mic, oh, get a, you go back to using your Yeti Blue. I was close to just going back to using my webcam and my Yeti Blue for some reason. I don't know why I do the things that I do, but that doesn't matter. We're just gonna taste some beer right now, so I hope this looks okay, I hope this sounds okay, and I hope that, well, those two things. I hope that it looks okay, and I hope that it sounds okay. So, the beer that I have to taste tonight isn't a beer that any of you could ever buy. This is going back like 2 years now. This is back to like 2014. I met a dude who goes by the name of Tactical War Mouse, okay? Tactical War Mouse, his name is Eric. Tactical War Mouse used to send me beer, like rare beers, and it turns out that he was also a home brewer, so he would also send me his home brew beers. And I think this is from 2015. I think this is over a year old. It might be a little bit older than that, but a while ago, so you know, a year, I want to say it was like a year and a half ago, he sent me some beer with a custom label that said, "What's in the beer, Robin?" The official, unofficial, official beer of the Grim Army. And he has tasting notes, like flavor notes. This is his home brew on here. A clever departure from the usual attitude. Hi, Nick. Welcome to reading. A clever departure from the usual attitude of cramming more hops to make an IPA. This white IPA uses fresh Michigan hops in just the right amount to make a great ale. Make sure you hashtag drink through the head like a man. Ignore your beer budget hands. And pardon me, chic. Remember, let's keep on drinking. So yeah, I have an area in my living room where I just keep beers. They're not cold, they're just beers. And then in the future when I think, oh, maybe I want to drink that beer, what I'll do is I'll just take that beer and put it in the fridge and then wait like a day and then enjoy the beer. So I've got this whole like bookshelf with one shelf that's just dedicated to just beer, and I was looking through there for a beer to drink in the vlog, and I found this way in the back, and I was like, holy shit, I still have a bottle of What's in the Beer, Robin, from Mr. Tactical Warmouse. This is great. So it's been, you know, IPAs don't necessarily age well. Fresh IPAs are always, always better than aged IPAs. So what I'm going to do today is drink this at least a year, maybe older, homebrew IPA from Mr. Tactical Warmouse. I follow Tactical Warmouse on Instagram, and he's always posting, you know, his homebrew beer stuff. It wouldn't be right to drink the official, unofficial, official beer of the Grim Army if I didn't drink it out of a Grim Army tulip style glass. So what I'm going to do is just pour the world's largest head. Wow, Nick, it's like I'm new here. Have I ever poured a beer before ever? that is just straight up ridiculous. I'm gonna wait for this head to dissipate a little bit. As we can see already, the level of effervescence is quite high. Good Lord, Nick. All right, well, it looks like that head has settled down a little bit. And of course, you know, like I always say, and like Ruby Roo has always said, I'm going to have to drink through this like a man. So cheers. Here's to you, Warmouse. I'm not sure if you still watch my videos. I am drinking your beer right now. I'm not sure how a year plus old IPA is going to taste, but you know what? Let's give it a shot. Let's drink through this head like a man. Well, it actually tastes amazing. Super clean on the drink down, super clean on the finish, very, very effervescent. I'm about to burp my face off right now, and I will be editing all of those burps out because that was just disgusting. But yeah, I'm surprised. IPAs usually don't age well. They take on like a weird, like woody, like tree barky flavor. This is still a nice sweet IPA. Super, super easy drinking beer, man. Just delicious. Very effervescent, very clean, very easy drinking beer. I would love, Warmouse, if you're still watching this video, I would pay you dollar money for like a six pack of this What's in the Beer Robin. I think it's just delicious. I have no idea what I'm going to pair it with. In fact, I don't even know what I talked about in my What I've Been Vaping, because this is a few days prior. This is 3 days prior to the vlog, and so much can change in 3 days. But the first thing I'm going to try is Titan Box Mod, Dot Mod Petri version 2, super secret juice on the inside. This is actually from the GrimmGreen Signature line, which I may or may not have talked about. If I did talk about it, then yes, it's from the GrimmGreen Signature line. If I did not talk about it, then don't say anything about the GrimmGreen Signature line. Anyway, this is a juice called Normal View. It is a cranberry orange sugar cookie. It is a stellar flavor. I think the tart citrus of the cranberry and orange is going to go really well with kind of like that tart sweetness from the IPA. So let's give this a shot. And I can feel another burp coming right now. Now that that burp is edited out as well, let's give this a shot. Good. That is a super good pairing. Super great pairing. I don't have anything else that I can pair with this. Nope. No dude juice. No that. No yig. No dripping fruits. Hit that juice. Nope. Sorry. This is the only juice I have on hand that will pair with this. And fortunately, it's a really good pairing. Yeah, good. Wow, that's good. Really good. Awesome. I'm glad this beer is good. I miss talking to Warmouse. He used to email me pretty frequently, and we would talk about beer and vape stuff. And if you're watching this video, Warmouse, I miss you, brother. I hope your beer brewing is still going good. I hope you're in a good place, and I hope you're still making some damn fine What's in the Beer Robin. So, yeah. That's what I got for my beer segment this week. I hope everything looks good and sounds good, like I keep repeating, like a broken freaking record. But now that we got that out of the way, I'm assuming, I can only assume because I've shot 3 years worth of vlogs. I've shot 3 years worth of vlogs. I need to go back and see when my first vlog was so we can kind of celebrate that as an anniversary. Maybe I'll find that date and I'll do a big giveaway or something. But anyway, after this many years of shooting vlogs, what always comes after... Oh, God. Sorry. That was my best Rick impression ever. What usually comes after the beer segment is shoutouts. Please tell me that everything is in focus. So yeah, hope you enjoyed tattoos. Hope you enjoyed beer, which I actually shot last night because I'm like, I'm drinking a beer. I'm going to film myself drinking a beer. Anyway, before I get into the shout outs, or I guess this could also be included in a shout out, I want to give a shout out to, where did it go? Joey from United Vapors. Sometimes I wear that United hat. It says United. That's from United Vapors. And Joey runs the UVN YouTube channel. He does his own reviews, but they have this great video up there. It's 28 minutes long. It's basically an advocacy, 100% advocacy video talking about the GCCs, the General Certificate of Conformity, the thing that we had to all go through, all liquid manufacturers had to go through just last week. It was a clusterfuck. I'm sorry. It was a clusterfuck. There was a lot of people that worked really, really hard, and we got screwed over a little bit on the dates of when caps can be in stores and cannot be in stores. There were a lot of shops with empty shelves because the manufacturers didn't provide the caps, the new bottles with new caps fast enough. Anyway, if you're interested in that, if you're a liquid person, if you're a vapor and you're just interested in advocacy, which you should be, definitely check out this. this video. I will link to it down in the description under the advocacy portion, but it's talking all about the GCC, General Certificate of Conformity, and it's a quick 28-minute video, much shorter than the vlog, much shorter than the vlog. For everybody wishing that the vlog was longer, just at the end of the vlog, go watch this. That'll tack on 28 more minutes. Anyway, so definitely shout out to Joey and United Vapors, absolutely. So I got to do a shout out for my good buddy Zeke. So Zeke, I met Zeke. Where did I meet you, Zeke? Where the F did I meet you, Zeke? EKG Builds. Where did I meet you, Zeke? Was that in New Orleans? Did I meet you in New Orleans? Was that the New Orleans event that I met you at? Anyway, Zeke's a builder guy, and he has launched his own website. He does great builds. He put a build on the Twisted Messes Squared for me, and it was, in fact, I think I still have it. I think the Twisted Messes Squared, no, it wasn't the Twisted Messes Squared. It was it was my black Twisted Messes version 1. I think I might still have that build on there, Zeke. Anyway, he has opened up shop. He's selling t-shirts and coils. He is a super, super good guy, just super funny, very, very down to earth, very, very humble about his building ability. You know what I mean? He's not like one of these cocky builder guys that's like, oh, yeah, whatever, just tricore fused alien hoof or whatever. He's super humble about it, and he's a really good builder, and he's really super dedicated to the craft. He sent me a couple of coils to check out, and what I like about his packaging is it tells you who he is, it tells you what it is, Tricore Aliens. That's probably why I said Tricore Aliens earlier. It's 36 gauge over 28 gauge at a dual coil. They'll come out to between 0.13 and 0.16. Tells you again on the inside everything, what the diameter of it is, what he wrapped it around, 2.5 millimeter diameter. And then inside the plastic, inside the case, is another little plastic baggie with your coils. So very, very cool. Definitely wish you all the success in the world, Zeke. You're a good guy, and you make really good coils. So if you're looking for some really good coils, why not support a good guy like Zeke? Head over to ekgbuilds.com, and I'll have a link down there in the description. And I was actually planning on wearing my EKG Builds t-shirt, and then I got sidetracked by my blue shirt because I looked so good in it, and then I forgot to wear it. I'll wear it in a different vlog there. There is a birthday coming up, okay? And I'm not going to do the shout out yet. This birthday, someone who sent me a birthday request, it's been sitting in my vlog notes, okay? And it's getting closer and closer. Just know that I haven't forgot about it. And on the birthday, I will do the birthday shout out. So I do have a couple shout outs to do. A fellow named Daniel wrote to me and said, "Hey Nick, my name is Daniel, and you can say my name in the video if you like." Let me move my microphone so this is easier. Oh, look at that. Look how much better that is. "I've been vaping for about 3 years now. My first rig was the Kanger Pro Tank on an Atmo mech mod. After many attempts off and on smoking, I finally kicked the habit of traditional tobacco, and I'm enjoying the benefits from it. Waking up, being able to breathe great, and even taste food has changed in a positive manner. Your videos have helped me to continue to vape and not smoke. Not only have I enjoyed your videos, but my fiance of 3 years, Jessica, is also to the point that she kicked the habit as well. That is awesome. She is currently on her second month mark. Without you, She is currently on her 2 month mark. Without you, I feel it might have been longer. I'm not sure exactly what that means, brother. It would be totally awesome if you could shout us out in an upcoming vlog. May the flavor of e-liquid and bittersweet hops fill your mouth hole with seduction." That is a great, good Lord. That is a great ending to an email. Absolutely. Daniel, you are shouted out. You didn't say her name. Did you say her name? Jessica, there you go. Your fiance, Jessica, boom. You are also both shouted out. Consider yourself shouted out. If there's one thing I love, it is couples that vape. And then I love more when one person vapes and the other doesn't, but the other's still supportive. Yeah. So moving forward into these shout outs, a fellow named Eric writes to me and says, "Hey Nick, my name is Eric. I started vaping a few years ago because my best friend Colin was getting into it to quit smoking. I grew up with Colin and I knew him ever since I was 7. He was murdered in 2014. And Eric, I apologize. That really took me by surprise because he just casually says he was murdered in 2014. That is fucking horrible. His death really impacted all the people around him a lot. Yeah, as it should. At the time, unfortunately, I was a heroin addict, and it sparked me into quitting and turning my life around, and that included vaping. Now, I'd like to think I vape in his memory. If you could blow him a flat, fat cloud and give him, myself, and my girlfriend Kristen a shout out, that would mean a lot. Oh, I'm a big fan of your videos, obviously, and I would like to either send you some beer or suggest you grab one from the company Umbrock. It's Le Fin du Monde. Yeah, Le Fin du Monde. I've had that. I've done that in a vlog, actually, I believe. Le Fin du Monde is freaking delicious. They also have another good beer called Trois Pistoles, yes, which I have also tried. Those are, you have great taste in beer. Yeah, no, you can't have my mailing address because I have those beers. I've had those beers readily available, but he wants a big fat cloud, and I have nothing to blow a big flat cloud. Let's get the Axis Vapes M17. Let's get the Kennedy 24. Let's get some Bro Trip in here, and let's blow a big fat cloud for Colin. That's about the biggest, fattest cloud I got for you, but definitely, Eric, you are shouted out. Colin, you are shouted out. And girlfriend, Kristen, you are definitely, absolutely all shouted out, man. That is just, it's a good story, but just the fact that his friend was murdered, I wouldn't know what to do if one of my best friends was murdered. Like, if Ruby Rue was just killed, I would die. Like, I wouldn't even know what to do. If Dwayne was killed, I don't even want to think about it. That just depresses me. I wouldn't know what to do with myself. I just wouldn't know what to do with myself. Let's wrap up these shout outs. Fella named, well, I'm going to call him Aziz. He wrote to me. He said I can call him Aziz. It's cool. He says, hey, Nick, my name is Abdulaziz. Yes, I know it's a long, confusing name, but you can just call me Aziz. Absolutely, Aziz. I'm calling you Aziz. I'm a 28-year-old guy. I'm from Kuwait. It is a small country in the Middle East. I just wanted to say I'm a huge fan of your YouTube channel and the podcast. I follow you on social media, and I just wanted to share my story. I began smoking at the age of 18. I smoked 1.5 packs a day. That is so much. Thinking back, now that we're vapors, thinking back to smoking an entire pack of cigarettes in one day, not to mention 1.5 packs of cigarettes in a single day, that just makes me so nauseous. Like, I can't even think about that right now. Anyway, he says, in August 2009, I collapsed in the hospital from H1N1, aka the swine flu. I went into a 55-day coma. When I woke up, I couldn't move any of my muscles. I was simply paralyzed, and I discovered that the doctors opened a hole in my windpipe, tracheotomy, because they told me while I was in the coma, both of my lungs collapsed. This guy, Aziz, you have been through the ringer and back. The doctors explained that the H1N1 is a disease that targets people with bad or weak lungs, and me being a smoker, 1.5 packs a day, I fell into that category. I went to Germany on a 7-month physical therapy rehabilitation center, and I began to smoke again. I know, I have no willpower. That's fine. Don't feel bad about that, okay? Smoking, it's not like smoking is just a thing that you just passively do and then give up. Smoking grabs your face. It grabs your mind and it gets in you, and it's hard. That's why we love vaping so much, because smoking is so hard to quit. He says, in late 2015, I went on vacation to the States. While I was in Miami, some guy at a hotel swimming pool was vaping. Thank you, guy from the hotel swimming pool. I came up to him and asked him what he was doing, and he told me all about vaping. At that moment, I threw my cigarettes away, went to the nearest vape shop, and bought myself a Joytech Evic VT, black with red stripes. And since that day, I have been smoke-free. I just wanted to say I'm sorry for my bad English and the long email. He's on Instagram at Aziz Al-Shalami, which I'm going to mispronounce your last name. I apologize. Definitely, absolutely. Aziz, thank you for sharing your story with me. You know what? As much as I complain about, like, oh, all these comments and, oh, all these emails, I love reading people's stories about quitting. And this one just, I don't know, it struck a nerve with me. He went through all this shit. He met some guy in a hotel swimming pool that was vaping. Hotel swimming pool that was vaping, that guy, without knowing it, just converted Aziz to be a vapor. So if you're out and you're vaping respectfully and you have the chance to talk to anybody who's smoking, proselytize, man. That's what we do. We get smokers to quit smoking. That's what vaping does. So congratulations, Aziz. Definitely, you are absolutely shouted out. And yeah, good time. So I think that's going to wrap up my shout outs. We've already been covered a whole lot in this vlog, and I don't want it to run any longer than it has to. So what we're going to do, I'm going to have to switch out some batteries, but we are going to get to some freaking first impressions right now. Oh, son of a bitch. See, I told you we had a lot of stuff to talk about, and sometimes things fall through the cracks. So Mooch, Battery Mooch. I'm going to post a link in the description to Battery Mooch's Facebook. He has a post on his Facebook right now. Wismec is releasing the RX2-3, which is what I'm talking about today in the first impressions. It has the ability to use two batteries or one battery, and he kind of talks about how do you pair up your batteries if you have a mod that can take both two or three batteries. Really interesting stuff. Additionally, he sent me a whole slew of new battery tests. There was one new battery, I can't remember the name of it, it started with an A, that was completely overrated and exaggerated and actually turns out to be a pretty dangerous battery. I love Mooch, I talk about him all the time. Follow Mooch on Facebook. Be his friend, like his page, follow his shit, because the battery information and knowledge that he has and that he's giving out freely to the world is really just invaluable. Additionally, there was one shout out that I forgot, and Jennifer Coleman, I love you. You are my favorite advocate of all the advocates that have ever been advocates. So I reposted her picture today on Instagram, but I just want to read it to you again. It's a picture of her. And then, oh, my brightness is way too high. Let's turn the brightness all the way down. It's a picture of her. And she's at the Capitol building. Then she has envelopes and letters. And let me turn my brightness back up. And she wrote, she posted this on Instagram and I reposted it. And I said, this is how you advocate. August 8th, do something. 102 letters dropped off at the California Attorney General Kalma Harris's office today. I know that as Attorney General, there is nothing she can do now. However, I dropped them off to her because she is the probable next senator of California after November. Forward thinking, Jennifer Berger Coleman. Forward thinking. She leads the current polls by no less than 21.9%. A huge thank you to everyone who sent letters and continues to do so. The count went up from 92 to 102 since yesterday. You can still email me your letters all week long. It's not too late. Tomorrow I'll be visiting a congresswoman's office as well. If you would like to write a letter for me to drop off, email. I'm going to put her email in the description. I hope she doesn't mind, but I am going to put her email in the description. And what you're doing is just basically sending your vape testimonials. It can be a couple of paragraphs. It can be one paragraph. Just say, hi, my name is Nick Green. I started smoking when I was in the seventh grade. I smoked about a pack a day until I was 27 years old. And then I discovered vaping and I've been cigarette-free, tobacco-free for the last 7.5 years. Just your vape testimonial. Send it to Jen. She prints them out. She puts them in envelopes and she gives them directly to the hands of these politicians. And that is incredible. I think it's really cool that she saw the foresight to say, hey, this girl might be the next senator. I'm going to give her a whole bunch of these vaping testimonials. I owe you so much, Jennifer Berger Coleman. I owe you at least a hug, at least a shout out in every vlog for the next forever vlogs. What you're doing is amazing, and I truly, truly appreciate it. So now we are going to get into some first impressions. So this first impression is this little Minikin guy, and I know I have a link for it. So Asmodus released the Minikin mod a while ago, and it was fine, and I liked it. It was okay, and I liked it. And then they did the 150 watt, which still has a review coming, much, much better. The Minikin 1.5 150 watt is just great. Don't want to ruin the review, but it is just great. And so now they've got this fancy, freaking fancy Asmodus 150 watt dual 18650 made out of freaking stab wood. Like I said, I have the recoil RDA on top. I got the little beauty ring on top. This has been just a delight to use. These are not cheap. They start at $299, which isn't ridiculous considering for this stabilized wood Axis Vapes M17, I paid $450 for it. So yeah, that's expensive. These start at $299, which isn't unreasonable. I've been loving this mod. There's no way around it. I've been loving it. I've been using it. I've been holding it. It's got clicky buttons. It's got a nice faceplate. It's got that Minikin whatever chip they're using on the inside. I love it for wattage mode. I don't use temp control. It has been just fantastic. This is a 0.2 at 74. Why is it 74.1? I hate that. I hate it when any mod says like 74.3. No, you either go to 74 or 75. That's it. That's, we deal in absolutes here. Really super comfortable to hold. It's bigger than the Minikin. If you're a huge fan of the Minikin and you want a Stabwood mod that's that exact same size, this is not it. It is bigger all around. It's wider and it's taller as well, but it still retains that somewhat, you know, Minikin look, the size of it, the flat front, the rounded back. It still looks and feels and performs like a Minikin. So here's my backstory on this. I'm using it. I'm loving it. I'm using it. I'm loving it. And then I got an email today, and Asmodus contacted me, and they are recalling all of the ones that they have already sent out. And I don't think any customers got any. I think it was only YouTube-y reviewer type people that got them, but they found a potential electrical issue in the way that the bottom is wired into it. And so they just want to go through all the ones that they've sent out and make sure that they're all assembled correctly. So tomorrow, I guess, I'm going to send this back to Asmodus. I hate to part with it. I literally hate to part with this. I've been using it so much. So much. I hate to part with it, but I'd rather be safe than sorry. So I'm glad Asmodus caught this right away. I'm glad this isn't, you know, 3 weeks from now and I'm doing a review for it and I go, well, it was great until, you know, the bottom circuit on my housing fried and fuck Asmodus. They caught it ahead of time. They said it's not in all of them. It's only in some of them, but they want them all back. They sent me a prepaid shipping slip that I can just put this in a box, put the slip on there and send it out the door. And I'm glad they caught it early, and I'm glad they're doing the responsible thing and bringing all these devices back. So hats off, Asmodus. I like the Minikin, and this Stabwood Minikin is sick AF. In fact, some of the blocks that they have on here, $5.99. This one that they have on here for $5.99 is beautiful. Beautiful. Oh my God, it's beautiful. Now, if Asmodus took this back from me, and here's where I'm saying this right now. If Asmodus took this back from me and said, oh, we're having a recall, just send it back. And then they said, well, if you want to review it, you'd have to buy it. I might buy this. I mean, I'm just saying right now, I might buy this. It is super cool. I love that they didn't send me a green one. Thank you, Asmodus. Don't send me a green one. I love the purple Stabwood. I think it looks so cool. So this first impression is going to be really quick because I hate it. Joytech sent out Joytech, you've made some great products. Joytech, like eLeaf, which I understand, I think they're the same company, are very, very hit and miss. Sometimes their mods are great. Sometimes they're terrible. Sometimes their coil heads are great. Sometimes they're terrible. The Joytech The Ultimo tank, awesome. Great coil heads. That could stand to have a lot more wattage put through it, but they're great coil heads. They are ceramic coil heads. I get zero spit back. I get pure flavor and pure performance. Joytech Ultimo, unbelievably good tank. The new Joytech EVIC AIO is just the worst thing ever. Looks super cool. It's an all-in-one. You have a little tank in here, and it's one of those tanks where you just fill it up and then you pull this out. It's like a dipstick, like, you know, top airflow here, and it goes down to the coil head. And this has been a nightmare since the second that I got it. I primed the coil very gently, put like 2 drops of juice in the coil, screwed it together, filled up the tank about halfway, plunged it all together, took one toot on it, great. I was like, wow, that is a really nice vape. By the time that I realized that this was a nice vape and went to take my second toot, I don't know if you can hear the amount of gurgle that's happening right now, but I'm scared to even vape on it because I know it's just going to shoot liquid hot magma into my mouth. But I'm going to give it a try. I have it set to wattage mode, 63 watts, 0.3 ohm coil, 4.42 volts. I'm about to get hot liquid lava in my mouth right now. Oh, can't do it. Shot right at my fucking tongue, man. God damn it. That juice is so tasty, I can taste it on my tongue. Bad. Bad. Really super terribly awful bad badness. This is the second coil head, and it did the exact same thing as the first coil head. It just fills full of juice and floods. And if this were any normal tank with that didn't have top airflow, this juice would have been emptied all over my desk by now. But because it's all self-contained and it has top airflow, it can only flood so far. It can only flood as high as the level is inside your tank. It's flooding like crazy. Joytech, get your shit together, man. These coil heads are just the worst. Otherwise, it's kind of a cool looking mod. They have a little extendo thing so that you can screw on a 510 and have an atomizer on top of here. And I think that's how I'm going to have to use it because I went through both coil heads already. I don't have a third coil head unless I open a new mod, which those are for giveaways. I don't really want to do that. Maybe some replacement coil heads would be nice, Joytech. Maybe ones that actually work. I don't even want to vape that again anymore. But the Ultimo tank, Joytech, really good job on this guy. That is the least spit back that I have ever got in a tank ever. And this is something, this isn't going to get a review, unfortunately. I've just talked about it in a bunch of vlogs. It's a great tank. If you're looking for a pure, clean tasting, zero spit back tank, check out the Joytech Ultimo. I think it's just a rad tank. I'm probably not going to review it. It's already been reviewed a bunch, and I have nothing new to bring to the table other than it's a great tank. I've put like already 70, 80 mils of juice through this tank, through this coil head, and it's still going strong with still zero spit back. It's rare. I've never experienced a vape with literally zero spit back. Even with some RDAs, even with the Kennedy, you still get a little tiny touch of spit back. That Supremo or Ultimo, why do I keep calling it the Supremo? The Ultimo tank, zero freaking spit back. It's kind of incredible. So moving on from that, I did want to talk about this guy as well. Both of these guys as well. Wow, I have a lot more first impressions than I thought I did. I got this. This is a DNA 75 device. Look how cool it looks. Can you kind of see that on film? It's got this C-frame sort of back clamp that goes on there. It's all really nice and shiny, futuristic carbon fiber. It's got like this sort of abalone button on there. This comes from a company called Think Vape. This is the Finder 75. I don't ever remember talking with a company named Think Vape. Oh, this ribbon is going to be the end of me, aren't you? I don't ever remember talking with a company named Think Vape. This just showed up. This is the Rider 75. It's a DNA 75, dual 18650 DNA 75, which is what I really, really like to see. Most DNA 75s are single 18650. So if you're rocking it at like a full 75 watts, your battery goes. This dual 18650, 0.24 ohms. I have it set to 45 watts. On top is the new Serpent Mini 25 millimeter. I have it set up at a single coil. This is a juice in here that I don't remember the name of, but I'm sure it's just delicious. I'm really liking this Serpent Mini, and I'm really liking it on top of this Rider 75. I don't even know. This just kind of came out of nowhere, but it is so appealing to me. I mean, the way it looks, it's got like this really dark gunmetal color. It's got that abalone button. It's got a DNA 75. It's got dual 18650s, and it's got this little slidey case that like slides on and stays. Is it gonna stay? Oh, it stays. It's really well put together. The fit and finish on this is kind of fantastic. I'm overly enjoying this right now. When I have to send that Minikin back, I'm gonna throw the recoil on this bad boy. We're gonna vape my face off. But yeah, really been enjoying this mod. But like with all my first impressions, I'm gonna spend a lot more time with it before I talk about it in a full review video. You never know what can happen 2 weeks from now. The board might fry, the contacts might break, this might bend, that could bend. I mean, a whole bunch of shit could happen. The button could break. There's a whole lot that could happen. Right now, I am really, really enjoying this mod, and I'm really enjoying the Serpent Mini 25mm on top. I am not 100% sure if I'm gonna do a review for this tank. It's the Serpent Mini. Serpent Mini 25mm version of it. It's literally the exact same as the Serpent Mini, just in a wider diameter. So just reviewed the Serpent Mini. Not sure if I'll do the 25. If you really are dying to see the 25mm review, let me know in the comments below. But otherwise, I'm just going to say, if you like the Serpent Mini, you will dig the 25. It gives you a little bit more airflow, a little bit more juice capacity, retains that same good Serpent Mini flavor. Sherbet in the dark. That's what is in here. Good. Wow, it's just a really good vape. I love vaping. Anyway, moving forward from that, let's talk about this. So this is the Reload. Let me get out the new back plate for it. New back plate. This is the new, okay. My drawer is, it's packed. It's overly packed with shit. So this is the new Reload RX2-5. So they released the Reload last year. Then this year they released the Reload RX-S, right? Which is new display, new mod, whatever. And then like right after that, pardon me, I have the hiccups right now and it's driving me insane. Let me get some water. God damn it. Okay, where was I? They released the Reload, then they released the Reload RX200S, which was an upgraded version of the Reload. And then just a few weeks later from the RX200S, they released the RX200. The RX2-3. So what this is it's a Reload. Same Reload board, same Reload feel. It's taller than the other Relos. It's a little bit taller, but it can run on either three batteries or two batteries. Interesting, right? I have been rocking it in three battery mode for a while now just because I like the way the Reload feels. This is the Mage RTA, which I just reviewed this week. Fucking wonderful, wonderful tank. Good. This is a really good vape. Now, if you press this button on the bottom pops off. Pops off right there. And so there's these little hinges on top, right? So you have one battery in the door and then two batteries right here. So what you can do is you can discard this. You can set this aside and then you can plug on this smaller. Let me make sure it's on right. You can plug on this smaller back plate. Goes in the little hooks, snaps on the bottom, kind of. And now you're in dual 18650 Reload. Look how much, I mean, it's like, you know, it's like half a Reload. It's like a tiny little Reload. It is just adorable and it looks cool. And now you're still getting the same performance. I'm still getting 50 watts, but now it's with two 18650 batteries. Maybe something that's a little bit easy to put in your pocket, right? So at home, you can have three 18650s, big Reload, just clouds, bro, clouds. And then you're like, hey, I'm going to leave the house. I'm going to swap out this tank. I'm going to put on the new backplate. Now I've got something a little bit more manageable, something a little bit smaller, same performance, dual 18650s, which is still great. It's just in a smaller all-around package, and you still get that same really nice Jabo Reload sort of fit and finish on it. I think it's really cool, man. Obviously, I want to spend a lot more time with this before I talk about it in a full review, but so far, man, I've really been enjoying this. Anyway, Jabo, Wismec, whoever you are, good job on this. I think it's cool. I think it's a bummer that this kind of outdates the Reload RX-S. Like, I really liked the S, and I was planning on doing a review for the S soon. But with this out, it doesn't seem, even necessary to talk about the S. It's this is the S, but with just way more features. Ah, I don't know. I get torn, especially now that we're coming down to the wire on August 8th and people are cranking out, you know, devices and RDAs and liquids and just cranking them out. Some more than others. Sense specifically has released I got 5 different tanks from Sense, of which I'm talking about none right now. I'm going to save those for later. But a lot of people, especially in China, a lot of Chinese companies are just a Joytech. Joytech has sent 5 different mods. Not just that one, but there's a new AIO thing. Where is it? This one that just came in today that I haven't even used. It's their new AIO all-in-one system. There's 2 new Evics. Watofo's sending out a bunch of stuff. It's panic mode, man. We're down to the wire. We're almost to August 8th. Anything that's on the market will be on the market, and nothing new can come to market. So, I don't blame them. I don't blame them for pushing all this stuff out. I'm just saying it gets overwhelming when it's like, oh, well, there's the Relo 200S, and then now there's the 2- or 2X3, and it's like a whole different mod that kind of, I'm just rambling. It kind of negates the RX200S, which I think is a great mod. Now that this exists, that one doesn't really need to exist anymore. Anyway, second to last is this Hotsig R150 guy. So I didn't put any batteries in it yet because I wanted to show you guys the inside. There's no ribbon on the inside for your battery compartment. Additionally, it's very confusing on the inside of this device, and I was actually terrified to turn it on. Overall, the fit and finish of it is nice. It's got this cool engraving. You can kind of see that all around it. It's got these fake abalone doors. It looks like a really expensive mod. But when you look in here, it's clearly marked positive here, up, positive here, down. So it's series. So you're putting your batteries in series. One positive up, one positive down. That is series. But then they have this huge warning printed in here that says, warning, parallel. What? This is like a riddle or something. It's like, oh, the Joker, he's got a box and it could be series and it could be parallel. And one way it's going to break and one way it's going to work. It confused the hell out of me. So what I did is I ignored the warning parallel warning. And I followed the positive warning. So I put this one in. Whoops, I almost fucked it up. Positive side down. Okay, nothing happened. And I put this one in, positive side up. Okay, it came to life. No big deal. Crisis averted. These panels, both of these abalone panels come off, which I'm kind of excited about. I want to see them do other panels, right? Just other panels, wood, stab wood, acrylic, different colors. I mean, branded, hell, could put the Ruby Crew logo on one of these. That would be sick as something that's sick. These just fit on here really well, really nice. It's on, I have this. It asked me if this is a new coil. Yes, 0.13 alien on here. Where's my fat panda juice? This is running at 75 watts in power mode. I haven't really fiddled around with any of the temp control stuff on this device because I've been so satisfied using it in parallel mode. I got this topped with the Goon. I got that Fat Panda. I like the buttons. They're nice and clicky. I like the feel of it. A lot of people are, it's going to draw comparisons to those Lost Vape, DNA 200 mods that are this same exact shape and size and with the engraving and with the abalone doors. This is more or less a clone of those sort of Lost Vape devices that are this exact same size with the engraving and the abalone doors and the DNA 200 on the inside. For those that can't afford really stupid expensive mods, Hotsig, that is why you exist. I hate the name of your company. I think Hotsig is a terrible name for a company, but I think this mod is actually very, very nice looking. I mean, this atomizer costs more than this mod. This titanium goon costs more than this mod. There you go. That's something to think about. I mean, not really. It doesn't really matter in the long run. It's just, I just found it interesting. No big deal. Stop bothering me. Great. That is a really great vape. This is one of my favorite vapes that I have right now. The goon with this, I can't ever remember the name of it. And I can't ever remember which panel to take off to look at the name of it. R150. Hot Sig R150. Yes. Obviously, I always say this, like with all my first impressions, I am going to spend way more time with this before I feel comfortable talking about it in a full review. But so far, it's just been really solid. Yeah. And something to keep in mind, man, as we get closer and closer to August 8th, after August 8th, there's going to be less and less and less first impressions. There are going to be no new products coming to the market after August 8th. Think about this. No new products on the market after August 8th. So my first impressions are literally what I have or anything that might arrive this weekend. That's going to be, what, maybe two, maybe three more vlogs of first impressions. I'm going to have to think of a new segment for the first impressions. Maybe I'll just get rid of first impressions. We can extend retro vaping. We can extend reviews for things that never got reviews. We can add a new segment. Does anyone want to see a new segment? I honestly have not even thought about it a little bit. Follow-ups to reviews that I did in the past. I don't know. More beer. I don't know. More tattooing. More something. Anyway, my last first impression that I want to do is everyone's favorite. It is a literal first impression. So this came from Wismec. Look at the size of this thing. This is the Vecino 3D. Now they released, let me grab it real fast. They released this little guy, the Vecino. Remember I talked about this. It's the, it takes an 18650 battery on the inside. It's got its own proprietary tank. This is filled with We Out Here Dough juice. Super nice. Dude, super nice vape. I really like this Vecino guy. Now they have quadrupled the fucking size of it. This is giant. I mean, this is a monster. This is a huge... Look how big that is. This is big. Big tank on top as well. Now, this doesn't take a battery, but you spin the bottom to adjust the voltage, right? Wow. Was anybody around in 2011? Anybody remember the Ego Twist? This is a gigantic reimagined Ego Twist. You adjust the wattage or adjust the voltage by spinning this bottom. So we have it. Where's the marker? Okay, so this is in bypass mode. So you're getting unregulated, I'm assuming 4-ish volts on here, right? This is 60 watts. This is 50 watts. This is 40 watts. This is 30 watts. This is 20 watts. This is 10 watts. This is 5 watts. 60 watts this goes up to. 60 freaking watts this goes up to. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn this all the way down to 5 watts. I'm going to fill up this tank. And here's something I noticed right away with this tank is if I attempt to just unscrew this tank from the body, here's what happens. Boom, the coil head gets left there. And then the base of the tank kind of stays on there. So when you're unscrewing and screwing this down, don't grab the tank, grab the base, because that way you can unscrew the whole thing without going bleh and just emptying freaking juice everywhere. The juice that I am dying to try in here is called, it's from Cream Vapors, K-R-E-A-M Vapors. Now, they make like these cream savers type of flavors. This is the fruity, this is like the fruity peachy one. Oh God, it smells so good. I smelled all of them. That one smells just the best. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to put like 2 drops. Ready? 2 drops into this coil head just to sort of get it primed up. That's soaking in. Fan-freaking-tastic. I'm going to screw this back together. And this has like... Whoops. What the heck's happening here? What's going on here, YouTube? What's going on? Why are you raised up? Why are you doing that? Why are you doing that? Okay, that was interesting. I'm going to screw this back together now. It's got bottom up. It's a sub-ohm tank, so obviously it has bottom airflow. But you adjust the airflow by rotating this little sort of disc on the bottom. Wow, it goes to 0 airflow. I think they're... Don't try to do mouth to lung. I'm going to try mouth to lung with this. But I got it set for... Clouds, bro, clouds. We're going to reattach this right here. We're going to hold the tank and unscrew the top because that's how you fill it. You have this huge open reservoir right there to just blah, blah, blah your juice all over the place. And so that's exactly what I'm going to do now. Watch it now and fast forward. Wow, this tank, I topped that way off, but this tank holds quite a bit of juice. I am surprised right now. I am surprised, surprised. All right, so let's close that down. Let me get to the website. I want to see how much juice this tank actually holds. I have a link for it here. Oh, we didn't talk about the other atomizer. Okay, we're going to have to do that real fast too. The Vecino 3DO. The 3DO? Are you kidding me? Does anybody remember the gaming system, the 3DO? No? Panasonic 3DO? Yeah, I thought it was great. Turns out it wasn't. Anyway, product introduction. The 3DO is the upgraded version of the Vecino. 30 millimeter diameter, 6 mil e-liquid capacity, and a 3,000 mAh battery capacity. Man, that is cool. I think this is so cool. So let's try it at, I don't know the resistance of this coil, but we're going to try it at a measly 5 watts. Nothing. Nothing happened at all. All right. How about 10 watts? Oh, okay. It was off. All right. So now we're just going to start off at 10 watts. There's no need to go back down to 5 watts. What am I, a crazy person? Okay. Why is it blinking at me? All right. So 10 watts isn't doing much. Okay. I can hear it crackling. Let's try 20 watts. A little bit of vapor is happening. Let's try 30. Let's just jump up to 40 watts. Nice. Oh, that juice is nice. Oh, that juice is so, so nice. All right, so 50 watts is where I think I'm going to leave it. The draw on this. Super good. A little loud, super good, nice and swooshy, not turbulent at all. That's my biggest pet peeve in RDAs and tanks is turbulence. This one, no turbulence. Vaping really, really well. Getting a little bit of spit back. Is the drip tip... Okay, so the drip tip is just this dinky little clear part at the top. This conical shape is like the actual top of the tank. Yeah, wow. Rocking and rolling, man. This is so cool. I think this is so cool. And I saved this. I've been looking at this for like 5 days now, just sitting. And I'm like, oh, I want to vape that so bad. And I'm like, no, I have to save it for the first impressions. I have to save it for the first impressions. And I keep looking at it and going, I want to vape you. No, had to save it for the first impressions. I'm glad I did. This is my genuine reaction. This is so cool. 3,000 mAh. It's variable wattage. You can turn this up to 60 watts, 50 watts, 40 watts, 30 watts. Let's leave it at 50 watts. Big clicky button on the front. Charges via USB on the back. Big 6 mil tank on top. And people always say that Wismec is Joytech is eLeaf. And I find that so hard to believe because I've had such good luck with the Wismec. Pardon me. God, okay, Rick. I've had such good luck with the Wismec coil heads in the Vecino, in other tanks, in the Armor Plus tanks. They're great. And the Joytech coil heads are garbage. So how can those be the same company? I ask you, how can that be the same company? Let's try a double two. Why not?
Vape capital.
Yeah, anyway, I'm excited to vape this. Does it fit in my mod holder? Oh, it does. Just perfectly fits into BB-8. I'm really excited about this thing. I think it's great. This juice from Cream Vapors, I'll post a link to it down in the description. Let me look it up real fast. I don't even know what the flavor profile of it is. I think it's like a fruity gummy saver. Cream Vapors liquid. Is that going to reveal anything? Cream Vapors. It's on ejuices.com, maybe. I am 21 or older. Yes. Okay, this is the peach cream saver. Peach cream saver. This is what? A 60 mil bottle, $27. So not a bad deal at all. Wow. I'm really surprised by that juice. That juice is actually shockingly, shockingly good. Now I'm afraid to try mouth to lung, even though I said I would try it. All right. That feels like mouth to lungy to me. Let's try it. Nope. That's bad. Bad mouth to lung. Bad mouth to lung. Nope. The problem is you can't just close off the airflow and have a mouth to lung vape. It has to be the right kind of airflow, the right kind of coil, the right kind of chimney. It all has to kind of come together. That's why the K-Fun Mini, you know, whatever, 3.1 was such a good mouth to lung vape. That's why the Aspire Nautilus Mini that I still use daily is such a good mouth to lung vape. That's why you can't take an RDA or a tank, just shut off the mouth ear airflow and expect to get a good mouth to lung vape, because it just won't happen. This is all about Clouds Bro Clouds, and I am really excited to freaking vape this. I don't even know the price. They don't have the price on the Wismec site, and I don't know. Nobody has it for sale so far. 5, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60 watts. I can't imagine this being more than like $40. If this is more than $40, maybe even $50, I would be surprised if it's $50. It's probably more along the lines of like $40 to $45 for this. I could be wrong. I could be way wrong on this, but the Vecino 3DO, it's the D3O. I kept saying 3DO, like the Panasonic 3DO game system. Fuck it, no matter what. I'm going to keep vaping this. I'm going to wrap up these first impressions. Unfortunately, I don't have a retro vaping, but I do have a review for things that never got reviewed, as well as a slightly annoying story that goes along with reviews for things that never got reviewed. So let's do that now.
Reviews for things that never got reviews.
All right, so let's hurry up and do a review for thing that never got reviewed. Now, here's my annoying story behind this. So what I'm going to be doing a review for a thing that never did get a review, is the Limitless RDTA. This is a great little thing, man. This is a rocking little vape. It's a rocking little tank. The way they built it is so incredibly smart and intuitive. You have this long post. So you have glass, you have the base, you have glass at the bottom, you have this long post with your deck, and that deck has threads. And then this part, your fill part, screws down onto those threads and seals up your tank. So great. And then you have a hole in the side that you can fill your tank up, right? Then you have a top cap with airflow holes, and that's what covers up your fill port, and now you have dripper style airflow holes on top, and then you have this big old chuff cap with adjustable airflow on top. It doesn't come with a drip tip, but the Kennedy drip tips, boom, fit in there and work great. This is a rockin' tank that I really, really enjoyed. So, as I was about to sit down and do a review for this, I saw that Limitless was releasing the RDTA Plus, and that really upset me. And I was like, well, I don't have an RDTA Plus. All I have is the RDTA. So why on earth, if you're releasing the Plus, why would I do a review for the RDTA? Because the Plus is obviously going to make the original RDTA kind of pointless, kind of stupid, kind of outdated, right? So I was all bummed out. And then like one day later, I got an email from Vapor Hub, and they're like, hey, we're going to send you the new Limitless Box Mod and the new RDTA Plus. And I was like, oh, perfect. That will work out so perfect, because I'll get the RDTA Plus, and I'll do a side-by-side. I'll do the RDTA and the RDTA Plus side-by-side video, just go over the differences. I'm already really super familiar with this tank, so I'll be able to point out differences, and it'll just be a really great, helpful video for people. That day never came because the RDTA Plus never came. This was 3 weeks ago. Never showed up. Hasn't showed up in the mail. No box mod. No RDTA Plus. Bummer. Just bummed me out. Like, I don't care. Like, if someone says we're going to send you something to review and then they never send it, then okay. I mean, that's fine. The last thing, I mean, I don't need another box mod. It's not like I need another Genesis tank or I need another box mod. What I like getting products for is to shoot videos for that could be helpful to people. That's the reason I'm bummed that I didn't get it. I really wanted to do this side-by-side comparison of the Limitless RDTA and the Limitless RDTA Plus. Package never showed up. 3 weeks ago, this package was supposed to show up, never showed up, never got a limitless box mod, which I would love to try and talk about. Didn't get one of those. I know, and it sounds like I'm complaining, but I'm really not, because I'm not going to lose any sleep over not having a limitless box. I just think they're cool, and I would have liked to talk about it on video for people that are curious about this box who may or may not necessarily want my input on it. Does that make sense? So anyway, the RDTA, let's talk about that. I have a 0.32 twisted 26 gauge build in here. I'm just gonna make sure it's glowing evenly, and then I'm gonna wick it up and I'm gonna vape the crap out of this. I loved using this tank, and I dismantled it when they said, oh, the RDTA Plus is on the way. So I'm like, all right, well, I better get this one clean, so when it gets here, right away I can do a little comparison video. That never happened, so I haven't got to vape this in a couple weeks. I'm gonna just strum these coils a little bit because they're not glowing super evenly. This is twisted 28 gauge, twisted 26 gauge, something like that. Yeah, there they go. They're going good. They're going pretty good now. Going pretty good now. Strumming is the best thing that's ever happened to coil building. Beautiful, Clark. So what I'm going to do is cool those coils down. I'm going to throw some wicks in there. I'm just going to be using some cotton bacon, which I don't know. I never used to like cotton bacon, and for some reason now I've like really, really been enjoying it. Now, the first couple times I built this, I stuffed that glass full of wick, and I don't think I'm going to do that this time. I think when I wick it, I'm just going to wick it, and I'm going to cut the wicks a little bit shorter than I did in the past. So yeah, if I'm just eyeballing this, I'm going to push my wick down. I don't know. I'm going to cut off a little bit. I used to just not cut off anything, but now I think I'm going to cut them off a little bit. I just want them to be a little bit shorter in the tank. Before, the whole tank was sort of packed with cotton, especially when you're using like a dual coil. It's a lot of cotton. It's a lot of freaking cotton. I'm just going to take my screwdriver. I'm going to push this down into these little channels right here, which is great. Super easy to do. Actually, I'm just going to use my finger. I'm going to push that down into that channel. Push that down into that channel. If you have them at the right length, the glass is actually gonna like hold down your wicks a little bit. I apologize, this isn't super thrilling entertainment, but it needs to be done in order for me to even start talking about this tank, this guy right here. So those are all into place. I'm gonna screw down this fill. It's got a fill hole on the side. Just screw this down. Be sure not to get any wicks in there. Done. So easy. And what I like to do is the same thing that I used to do on the theorem that Matt showed me, where I kind of like move the wick a little bit to the side just to create, you know, a little bit of a gap. You want a little bit of an airflow gap in there. I am trying this mystery juice. I don't know where it came from. It's called Southern Draw Premium E-Liquid Goober. I was going through and cleaning out some of my old juices. This goober just kind of smelled like a good juice. So I'm going to juice up these coils real fast before I completely fill up the tank. Juice, juice, juice. You are wet. You are wet. You look good. You look good when you're wet. Push the button. All right, very piddly vapors are happening. It's probably because I have this set to 40 watts and it's a 0.4 ohm coil. So we're going to turn this up to about 70 watts. There we go. That's a little bit more of the vapors that we're used to. So this is super easy to fill up. Get the coils wet. Super easy to fill up. There's a big open hole on this side. Big, huge, kidney-shaped hole. So all I do is I hold it kind of away from me, I guess, and I make sure that the juice is going in one side and air is coming out the other side, and you're good to go. You got nothing to worry about. It's a little bit difficult with this glass dropper. I'm getting kind of juice everywhere, but let's get this tank filled. Glass dripper bottle was probably not the best idea for filling up this tank, but you know what? It still seems to be working. It's just a little bit more tedious. All right, well, I finally got it, you know, mostly full. If you know the Limitless logo goes right side up, boom, it goes right over your juice fill hole that you were previously using. And when I was using this, I like to turn the airflow down about halfway. Just adjust that halfway. Sure. So let's vape it. And this is a great vape. This thing rips hard like an RDA, but it's got a tank at the bottom. So if you want to re-wet your coils, re-wet your wicks, if they're long enough, they can be down in the tank. If not, you kind of do one of these jobbers and it re-wets your coils. I thought this was a really great tank and I really liked the way the plus looked. Unfortunately, I couldn't do a plus and RDTA plus, you know, side-by-side comparison. Anyway, 0.3 ohms. Let's turn this down to 60 watts and let's just pull. Good Lord. Great, smooth, swooshy airflow. Really nice flavor. This juice tastes like hot sweetness in my mouth. I can't really pick out any flavors from it. It's good. It's a good vape. And if I want it to be wet again, I just hold it upside down, watch two bubbles happen. Now I know for sure that my wicks are all nice and wet on the inside, baby. And then you can just keep vaping it. Now, when I had the wicks all the way down into the tank, it held less juice in the tank. It reduced the capacity quite a bit, but it would wick the tank completely dry. I could just vape this, and it would suck up all the juice from the tank. I mean, like a sponge. Now that I have the wicks cut shorter, I do have to flip it upside down. Let's watch like one or two bubbles happen. And now I know everything's nice and wet in there. Really good, really, really good tank. Also reasonably, reasonably priced. They're in stock right now at Vapor DNA for $40. If you've never tried like a Genesis style tank, so far in my experience, this is one of, if not the best Genesis style tank that I've used this year. And I think it's just great. I think it's super cool. I've got a couple to give away. I am trying to think of how to do a giveaway. I might not do one this week, but I might do one next week. I just didn't give it enough thought this week. That's the only problem. I had so much fucking going on with that GrimmGreen signature juice line, with all of this advocacy going on, with just so much shit going on with the CPC caps and all this stuff. I didn't get around to thinking of a giveaway, but whatever. I'm just gonna vape this and enjoy it right now. Great. It's just a really great vape. So yeah, I highly recommend it. It's coming highly recommended. That's all my review would have been. I would have been like, here's how you build it. Here's how you wick it. It vapes fucking great. Highly recommend it. I'm not a fan of using it without a drip tip in it. I mean, it's fine. It might get a little bit spitty in there, but Kennedy drip tip, boom, they fit in there just perfect, which means that a Goon drip tip would fit in there just perfect. I think they're great. I really like the Limitless RDTA. I think it's a great, great tank. Highly, highly recommend it. And yeah, I think that's going to wrap this up. No more reviews for things that never got reviewed. What I have to do now is end this vlog with my favorite comments of the week. All right, well, let's do my favorite comments of the week. So if you don't listen to my podcast, me and Ruby Roo do have a podcast called The Culture of Clouds. You can find it at cultureofclouds.com as well as SoundCloud on Culture of Clouds as well as iTunes. You can just search Culture of Clouds. But we had a whole episode dedicated to trolls. It was called Troll Corner. And we just read some of the, you know, we talked about trolls, why they do what they do, why they're compelled to share their shit with everybody. And, so I wasted, well, not wasted, it was content for the podcast, but I had a bunch of comments of the week. Now it's dwindling down, but I got this one. So this one was actually on Ruby Roo's vlog, her VCCPA vlog, and Lightning3034 says, "Why does it always look like GrimmGreen is flaring his nostrils? Does it always look like I'm flaring my nostrils?
I don't know if it always looks like I'm flaring. Does it? Let me know in the comments. Does it always look like if I'm flaring my nostrils? And Ruby Roo just said, he's just a super intense person, I suppose. And yeah, that is definitely absolutely true. This one was actually on Facebook. And in that podcast, it talked about how I rarely ever get trolls on Facebook. But someone left this comment that said, this is referring to the VCCPA travel vlog. He said, by far the worst video you have ever made. Teachable moment, Nick. Should have scrapped that one, bud. Well, a lot of other people really liked that video, and I really liked that video, and I really liked filming and editing that video. So sorry, bro. Sorry, not sorry. This guy just left a comment, and from now on, I'm editing out all the names because you don't deserve to have your name said unless it's, you know, a funny, constructive comment or a funny comment from someone I know. If you're just a troll, you're getting your name deleted. This guy just said, you are a fag, sir. Sure. I don't know what fag, sir, means. Maybe that's how they talk in Boringand. I have no idea. Got another one here. This one was actually hilarious. So a guy named Scott Michael Keller left a comment on the VCCPA vlog that said, we watch your videos because you're unique. And then he commented right away, 1 minute later, underneath it, that said, wow, unique e-cigs was in the next shot. LMFAO. I've never used that word in my life. I just thought that was hilarious. So I guess second to last comment of the week. This guy felt compelled so much that he had to write it twice. He just wrote, dickhead, twice. Just twice. I guess that's a thing if you're going to do that. Finally, this one, whose name I blocked out, this was also on the VCCPA travel vlog. He said, I hope the FDA rapes you all in the ass, ye Pokemon Go loving cunt faggots. So, awesome. I don't know what cunt faggots means. That's a ridiculous statement. People just crack me the F up. So this is it. This is the last comment of the week. I want to end on a high note. A guy named Dirk Diggler, who I'm assuming his name is not Dirk Diggler. If you remember, like a week ago, I had a comment from that guy in Delaware who said, I want to watch you eat dinner. And I just thought that was so hilarious / borderline creepy. Well, this guy left a comment and said, Nick, fuck watching you eat dinner. I want to eat your dinner. Trump is a reptilian. Really well done. Really well done. Fuck watching me eat dinner. That's right. He wants to eat my dinner, which could be like a sexual innuendo. I have no idea. Like, if you see a really hot girl, you'd be like, hey, I want to eat your dinner. Is that like a pickup line that would actually work? Anyway, I think we're getting down here to the end of the vlog. Let me take a quick look around the room and see if I forgot anything. Yeah, I did. But we're going to save it for next week because I'm done. I haven't eaten dinner and I haven't showered. And I'm going to go have a shower with some shower beers. And then I'm going to have dinner and I'm going to watch fucking Rick and Morty because that's one of the greatest shows ever on television. Anyway, that's what I got for today, everybody. Thank you. Thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Remember that August 8th is this weekend. Do everything you can before that to fight for your vaping rights. You don't have to do everything, but you do have to do something. Reach out to Jennifer Berger Coleman, one of the greatest advocates of all time. Send her your testimonials so she can hand deliver them to politicians. And you know what? After August 8th, I'll have a vlog after August 8th. And in fact, let me tell you this. I'm not going to have any reviews next week. So just be forewarned, next week, no reviews. I'm going to have a vlog, and we are going to have a podcast, but next week, I have no reviews. I've got some people coming into town, and it's just messing up my whole schedule. I'm not going to have any reviews next week, but the week after that, we're going to get back on track, and then the week after that, I'm going to be in Dallas for the Dallas Vape Showcase, which I'm really excited about as well. Let me know if you want a travel vlog. To those that have made it this far in the vlog, let me know if you want a travel vlog for Dallas Vape Showcase. I wasn't planning on doing one, but if you want to see one, let me know, because travel vlogs are always fun, but I wasn't planning on shooting a travel vlog. The only reason I'm going to that event is because I found a cheap flight and a cheap hotel, and I've never been to Texas. And I know there's probably a lot of cool people in Texas to meet, and I've never been there. So Dallas, Texas, Vape Showcase, I will be there, and I'm stoked to meet everybody there. Anyway, let's wrap this up. Thank you so much for watching, everybody. And as always, right there, limitless on the 44. Let's keep on vaping.